You know, when we look at a pretty flower, we say, oh, what a nice picture. And we only see it at that moment, in that image. But if we look a little more closely, with a trained eye, we say, well, what is the flower? Oh, what is the reality? This one is dying. This one is dead. This one is growing. Is it this one? This one or this one? No, cannot be. Nothing down there? Ah, the reality is a process. It's a process of arising, becoming, and ceasing, and ending, ever continuing, as long as the conditions requisite for continuing nourishment exist. Oh, look. Oh, look. I come down here and I see it's not this one, it's not this one, it's not this one. It's this one. This is the flower. Now, wait a minute. That's not the way that it should be. That's not what I expected to be at all. And the way we look at all phenomena are the way we expect them to be. We expect the flower to be in bloom and not to be dying, not to be in the process of gradually decaying and going back to the earth and becoming part of nature again. But then if I look down here, oh, I see the same plant again, but this time in an earlier stage where the plants are still, the leaves are still green, and we can see the flowers. Ah, now this is the way it should be. We say to ourselves, oh, this is the way I want it to be. But life is never like that. Life is never the way we want it to be, because life is a continuum that is ever flowing and never ceasing. It with energy, arising and ceasing, arising and ceasing, arising and ceasing, again and again, through processes from beginning to middle to end to death and ceasing. And that's as true of any phenomena in the world as it is in the human body.